Hi students, welcome to the class of theory of computation organized by Horisoft. So till now we have looked at a specific kind of language that is called as regular language. Okay, now for a regular language we have taken two approaches to describe a regular language. One approach is called as machine way of looking at a language. Okay, in which we have discussed three kinds of machines that accepts a regular language, that is DFA, deterministic finite automata, NDFA, and that is non-deterministic finite automata, and NDFA with empty transitions. Okay, and we have seen that from one kind of automata or one kind of machine I can always construct another kind of machine in case of a DFA, NDFA and epsilon NDFA. Also in the last class we have looked at another way of creating or building the words of a regular language, and that is through regular expressions. So regular expressions, as I had already told you, they are basic atomic expressions on which I apply some operations like union, concatenation and clean closure to generate the words of a given regular language. And we have seen that if a language is regular, that means there always exists a corresponding regular expression, and if there exists a regular expression, that means there I can always create a machine to accept that regular expression, or to accept the language generated by that regular expression. So what we'll discuss today is we'll discuss another property of that defines a regular language. Okay, so a regular language also holds another property called as pumping property. Now this pumping property we'll discuss is described in terms of a theorem or a lemma called as pumping lemma. Okay, so how this pumping lemma looks like? So let us start our discussion on pumping lemma. So in exam you can see that always there a question has been asked in the previous years to prove that a given language is not regular using pumping lemma. Okay, so we'll discuss those questions today. So before that, let us come to the theorem first. What does pumping lemma says? Okay, so the pumping lemma is defined as a if then format. So if, what is the condition? If my language is regular, okay, and it satisfies some constraint, extra constraints, then it satisfies the pumping property. Okay, so let me go to the formal definition of a pumping lemma. So let us start. So if L is a regular language, what does this mean? Regular language means which can be accepted by a deterministic or a finite automata. Automata of suppose the number of states of the finite automata having number of states equal to suppose capital M, okay, or capital N, okay, and there exists a string which belongs to L and is sufficiently long. So what does this sufficiently long means? The sufficiently long means the length of the string is greater than or equal to n. Okay, I'll write that. okay, sufficiently long, and the which implies, this implies the length of the string is greater or equal to number of states of the automata that accepts. Okay, comma. So what is the number of states of the automata? That is capital N, we have already written. Now if this is there, so that means my language is regular, it is accepted by a finite automata of n states, and in the language there exists a word whose length is more than or equal to n, okay, and which can be, and the string can be decomposed as, so let denote the string w by let us denote the string w, okay, which is sufficiently long, decomposed as, so I can write w as w is equal to x, y, comma z. So what does this mean? That means I can decompose the string w into three substrings x, y, z such that the concatenation of x, y and z constitutes w. Okay. With the constraint, that mod x, that means the number of symbols in the substring x and the number of symbols in the substring y, okay, is less than or equal to the number of states capital N, okay, and I can say that the y is the, and the another constraint is the substring y should contain at least one, should consume at least one symbol, okay, so it is greater than or equal to one. So if these conditions are satisfied, then for every value, so this is the if condition. So if L is a regular language which can be accepted by a finite automata having the states of the automata, number of states of the automata is equal to n suppose, and the language contains a word which is sufficiently long, and the notion of long, sufficiently long, implies that the length of the string is greater than or equal to the number of states of the automata, okay, that accepts this string, and we can decompose, and if we can decompose that string into three parts, that is three substrings x, y and z, with the constraint that number of symbols in x plus number of symbols in y is less than or equal to the total number of states, and the y substring should contain at least, should consume at least one input symbol, okay, that means mod of y should at least greater than or equal to one, then for any value of I greater than 0, the following condition, so 0, the new string w1 which is equal to, let me write it down, what is w1, so w1 is represented like this, so w1 is equal to x y to the power I z also belongs to language L. Understood? So this is the formal definition of a pumping lemma. Okay, so let us try to see it through a small example, how the pumping lemma holds. Okay, so let me first draw a simple deterministic automata. Suppose I have a question. So suppose any string